Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Logic. In this video, I will show you how to reduce the number of terms in a syllogism so we can put it into standard form and then test it for validity. Now look at this syllogism. Notice it has four terms. Now we can reduce it to three terms and put it into standard form by obverting the first premise. The new syllogism is logically equivalent to the original syllogism. And that's how we do it. We take the syllogism that has more than three terms, and we create a new syllogism that is logically equivalent to the original. And we do this by using the operations of conversion, obversion, and contraposition. See previous videos for more information on those operations. It's important that the reduced syllogism is logically equivalent to the original syllogism. You cannot use conversion on A or O propositions or contraposition on E or I propositions. Now look at this syllogism. First, we find the conclusion. Look for indicator words. The conclusion indicator word in this syllogism is the word so. So write the conclusion on the bottom and the premises above. And next, symbolize the argument by replacing the terms with letters. Then we reduce the terms by using conversion, obversion, and contraposition. Now, since the first premise is an O proposition, we can contrapose it. The second premise is an E proposition. We can first convert it and then obvert it. And presto! We now have a syllogism that is logically equivalent to the original syllogism, but now it only has three terms. Now, to finish putting it into standard form, the major premise goes first, followed by the minor premise. So we switch the order of the premises. Now that it's in standard form, we see that the form is an AOO3, and it has an illicit major. Since this syllogism is invalid, the original syllogism is invalid. Practice problem time. Which statement is the conclusion? Now press pause if you need more time. The answer will appear in 3, 2, 1. The indicator word because helps identify the premises. Next, symbolize the terms with letters. Press pause if you need more time. The answer will appear in 3, 2, 1. This is the correct symbolization. Next, reduce the terms by eliminating the negations. Press pause if you need more time. The answer will appear in 3, 2, 1. This is the correct reduction. Next, choose the syllogism that is in standard form. Press pause if you need more time. The answer will appear in 3, 2, 1. The premise containing the predicate of the conclusion is the major premise, and it goes first. Is the new syllogism valid or invalid? Press pause if you need more time. The answer will appear in 3, 2, 1. It's valid. Therefore, the original syllogism is valid. Next practice problem. What statement is the conclusion? Press pause if you need more time. The answer will appear in 3, 2, 1. This is the conclusion. Now, the indicator word is so. Next, symbolize the terms. Press pause if you need more time. The answer in 3, 2, 1. This is the correct symbolization. Next, reduce the number of terms by eliminating the negations. Press pause if you need more time. The answer in 3, 2, 1. This is the correct reduction. Next, choose the syllogism that is in standard form. Press pause if you need more time. The answer in 3, 2, 1. This one is in standard form because the major premise is first. Is the syllogism valid or invalid? Press pause if you need more time. The answer in 3, 2, 1. Invalid. The fallacy of illicit minor is committed. Next practice problem. Identify the conclusion. Press pause if you need more time. The answer in 3, 2, 1. This is the conclusion. The word thus is the indicator word. Next, symbolize the terms. Press pause if you need more time. The answer will appear in 3, 2, 1. This is the correct symbolization. Next, reduce the number of terms by eliminating the negations. Press pause if you need more time. The answer will appear in 3, 2, 1. This is the correct reduction. Put the new syllogism into standard form. Press pause if you need more time. The answer in 3, 2, 1. This one, the major premises first, followed by the minor premise. Now, is the syllogism valid or invalid? Press pause if you need more time. The answer in 3, 2, 1. The syllogism is valid. Next practice problem. Identify the conclusion. Press pause if you need more time. The answer in 3, 2, 1. This is the conclusion. The word so is the indicator word. Next, symbolize the terms. Press pause if you need more time. The answer in 3, 2, 1. This is the correct symbolization. Next, reduce the number of terms by eliminating the negations. Press pause if you need more time. The answer in 3, 2, 1. This is the correct reduction. Is the new syllogism in standard form? Press pause if you need more time. The answer will appear in 3, 2, 1. The new syllogism is in standard form. Now, is the syllogism valid or invalid? Press pause if you need more time. The answer will appear in 3, 2, 1. The syllogism is valid. Very good job on those practice problems. Now you know how to reduce the number of terms in a syllogism in order to put it into standard form and test it for validity. You are now one step closer to advancing to the next level. See my other videos on logic. Comment, like, share, and subscribe, and have a great day.